Hello, and in today's British English pronunciation lesson, you're going to learn how to say T-I-O-N and how to say S-I-O-N in British English. Are you ready? So first, let's have a look at how to pronounce words ending T-I-O-N. Now, T-I-O-N has four letters, but we only have two sounds. Well, officially three sounds, and the sounds are sh, like shop, which is the schwa sound, and n. However, the schwa in the middle often gets eaten by the two other sounds, as this syllable is extremely, extremely short. So, my recommendation is to just pronounce the sh and the n sound, shn, shn. For example, conversation, conversation, shn, shn. Information, information, shn, shn. Education, education, shn, shn. Situation, accommodation, station. Okay, I've given you many examples already. Can you hear where the stressed syllable is in all the examples that I've already given you? That's right, the stressed syllable is the syllable immediately before shn. Listen again. Conversation, information, education, situation, accommodation. This is a really great rule which doesn't really have any exceptions. And it's also true when we add more suffixes to the end of the word. So, nation has the stress directly before shn. This is a noun. Let's make it an adjective. National, national. Again, T-I-O-N is pronounced shn, and the stress is on the syllable directly before shn. National, national. Let's make it an adverb. Nationally, nationally. Again, we have the shn pronunciation and the stress is directly before that. Nationally. You want to put a prefix before that word? That's fine. Internationally. Again, we have shn and the stress is directly before shn. Simple. Now, as I said, there are not many exceptions to this rule, but there is one very common exception, and that is the word question. Question, question, chin. Yeah, in this case, we don't have the sh sound, but we have the ch sound, like church or cheese. Ch-ch-ch, chin. Question. Now, before I tell you how to say words ending S-I-O-N, let me just tell you one more thing about words ending T-I-O-N. The cool thing with these words is that you can almost invent them. I mean, you take a verb, and if you want to make the noun of that verb, in many cases, you can just add the shn sound. So, we take a verb, collect, and if we want to turn that word into a noun, we add shn. Collection, collection. You'll notice in this situation, I delete the T of collect and just add shn, collection. Some more examples which work in exactly the same way are subtract, subtraction, act, action, donate, donation, infect, infection, connect, connection. So sometimes it's very, very easy to create a noun if you know the verb. What I recommend doing if you learn the verb donate is, at the same time, learn the noun, donation. Because sometimes it's really easy, like this, or sometimes the word is similar and easy to remember, but it doesn't exactly follow this rule. Like, converse is a formal word of talking. Converse, conversation. Repeat, repetition. Explain, explanation. Evolve, evolution. And pronounce, pronunciation. So they're all easy to understand and they're all easy to remember if you know the verb. Okay, let's have a look at how to pronounce words ending S T-I-O-N now, because it's very similar. So let's do T-I-O-N again. That's shn, shn. Take the first sound of that, shh, and while you're pronouncing that noise, start vibrating your throat. Sh, zhn, zhn, zhn. That is the pronunciation of the S-I-O-N suffix. Not too complicated. Some examples of words ending S-I-O-N are television, television, zhn, zhn. Decision, decision, zhn, zhn. Occasion, zhn, zhn, zhn. So again, we don't want to make a big deal of the vowels, I-O. It's not decision. Again, we have the two sounds, very, very quick. Zhn, zhn. Version, excursion, immersion, zhn, zhn. If you want to learn more British English pronunciation with me, there's more videos there for you. And of course, you can join me inside my pronunciation course by clicking the link in the description. So thanks for watching this lesson. I'll be in touch next week with more. Until then, bye for now.